So I guess it's time for me. My wife once in a while says, we just want to see what happens when you open your mouth. So we'll see what happens here this morning. It's good to see you this morning. Good to be in God's house fellowshipping. And good to have you folk with us on Facebook. We're here to worship. We're here to praise our Heavenly Father. Is He worthy of it this morning? Amen. It's good to have you out this morning. A few things we do want to remember. Naturally, the worship service at the present time that we're involved in. And as soon as we're done here, we're going to have our monthly fellowship dinner downstairs. So plan to stick with us. And we'll see what we can do to feed you and take care of those needs. 5 o'clock this afternoon. Make sure you're on Facebook once again for the Bible study. The pastor will be conducting that. And then Monday, I don't know if you pray on Monday night when he has a Bible study there, but 5:30 on Monday night, he does have a Bible study with the Hellfighters and the people that want to join there. So remember him in prayer on that time. We want to mention Wednesday. We're here. Amen. In person, Wednesday night prayer service, a very short Bible study, but the emphasis is on our prayer. As a corporate body, we can come before our Heavenly Father with things that's on our heart. The church does keep a list up to date of prayer requests and things that we're praying for on Wednesday night, along with your personal prayer list. We can do that as a group, even though we're private. So make sure you grab that prayer list on the back. Let the pastor know if you have things to add to it. And he will do that, and he will also send it out to you by email. I want to mention, 2 weeks from this Sunday, October 10, we had some missionaries, Jeremy and Jody Smith, were supposed to be here during 2020, unable to have them here. That was canceled out. They've rescheduled. That will be here on October 10. So plan to be here for them, young people that run around the United States, planting churches, building churches. Find out what's up in their life. Find out what they're doing recently. I call them young people because they're younger than me. So that makes them young, doesn't it?
Amen.
Come and spend the day with us October 10 as they come and give a report on their work and what's happening in their lives. When missionaries come, it always gives us an insight of what's been happening, and we get an insight of things that they are listing on their prayer list for us to pray with them about. So if we want to stay up to date, we've got to spend time with them. Other than that, tomorrow will be the visitation for Sandy Lincoln at Woodley Funeral Home, 11 to 1, correct? So Woodley's tomorrow at 11 to 1, and then they're going to have a private graveside service. So the family will be there at that time. Good to have you with us this morning. We're going to praise our Heavenly Father with some song and some praise, and then we're going to look into God's Word as it's opened up. Every time the Word of God is opened up, there's something for each and every one of us, whether it's a blessing, whether it's a challenge, whatever the case may be, there's something for each one of us. So let's bow in a word of prayer, asking for God to deliver that this morning. Thank you, Father. Excuse me. Thank you, Father, for the morning that you've given to us. Thank you for the beauty of the day. Thank you for your faithfulness, Father. You supply our needs daily. You take care of us daily. You give us opportunity to be a witness and a testimony. Father, we think of that testimony this morning, how precious it is. Father, we ask this morning that you'd guide and direct, cause us to be mindful of that and have the desire to want to protect that testimony. Guide and direct there. We think of the activities of this week coming up. Every one of us in this room have activities that we say we're going to take care of this week, things that we want to take in consideration, we want to make room for. But Father, ultimately, we want to pray for your direction in our lives. You have the week ahead of us planned out. Cause us to be open and receptive to that. Give us the people that you want us to speak to. Give us the activities that you want us to engage into. Guide and direct in everything that is done in this up and coming week. Cause us to be mindful to want to follow your will and direction. We think of those that are sorrowing today. We think of the Lincoln family and kids gather together. Father, the fellowship tomorrow is the kids will all be available for the time together. And then the service, cause their hearts to be open and receptive to your word. As it's delivered, we ask that you speak to hearts. Guide and direct there. We ask this morning that you would direct this service this morning. Cause us to be open and receptive to your word as it's given. Cause us to be receptive to the point where you can speak to us. Cause us to react with decisions in our life. We ask that you'd be with us as we sing praises to you this morning. Guide and direct there, and we give you the praise and the glory. Amen. You know, I was thinking earlier this week as I was working in the yard. At West Des Moines, they have every year people volunteer for opening their house up and everything like that so people can come in and see what their house looks like. And it's like kind of a parade of houses that you can see and things. And I was thinking earlier, as you walk up to these houses, you may come up to a house that has a lawn that is pristine, not a weed in it. Not a thing that you can find fault with. Go through their house. Then you may go to a house and that yard is not kept up quite so well. And you ask both of them, what do you do to your yard to make it look the way it does? What one are you going to take note of? Which one are you going to follow the instructions of? The guy with a pristine yard, because he knows what he's talking about. Amen. That's the way we should be with our testimonies. As we're out and about weekly and daily, people ought to know by looking at you and talking to you, that guy knows what he's talking about. His life lives what Christ wants it to live. So we should strive to protect that testimony. We should work at it, do what God has for us. The opening here, what a wonderful Savior. He's able to do that for us this morning. I'm looking at number 81. And our hymnal says, you stand up, please. At home, sing with us also. Christ has for sin atonement made. What a wonderful Savior. We are redeemed, the price is paid. What a wonderful Savior. What a wonderful Savior is Jesus, my Jesus. What a wonderful Savior is Jesus, my Lord. I praise him for the cleansing blood. What a wonderful Savior. Well, reconcile thy soul to God. What a wonderful Savior. What a wonderful Savior is Jesus, my Jesus. What a wonderful Savior is Jesus, my Lord. He cleansed my heart from all its sin. What a wonderful Savior. And now he reigns and rules.
wonderful Savior. What a wonderful Savior. In Jesus, my Jesus. What a wonderful Savior. Is Jesus, my Lord.
306. Jesus saves. 306.
We have heard the joyful sound. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. When the tidings all around. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Bear the news to every land. Climb the steeps and cross the ways. Onward 'tis our Lord's command. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Put on the rolling tide. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Tell the sinners far and wide. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Sing the islands of the sea. With the heart. Jesus saves, Jesus saves.
Let's see what number two or number three does. What is it? Okay. So let's go to three now, okay? Which is actually two. Okay?
We're on the rolling tide. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Help the sinners far and wide. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Echo back the ocean caves. Earth shall keep a jubilee. Jesus save, Jesus.
A last stanza.
Give the winds a mighty voice. Jesus save, Jesus saves. Let the nation now rejoice. Jesus save, Jesus saves. Shout salvation full and free. Highest hills and deepest caves, this our song of victory. Jesus saves, Jesus saves.
I look at my wife once in a while, she's giving me signals, so she's sign languaging to me. I know, man, there's something wrong again. I only know that signal because her sign language is in Dutch. So it's different than anything else. It works for me. 180 as we continue. Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb that was slain. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power. And wisdom and strength, honor and glory and blessings. Worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb that was slain. Worthy is the Lamb.
Let's sing it one more time, please.
Worthy is the Lamb that was slain. Slain. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength, honor and glory and blessings. Worthy is the Lamb, oh, worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb that was slain.
God, this morning, thank you very much for your singing. Y'all may be seated. Pastor?
Glad you're here today. Glad you joined us. I'd like to ask you to turn your copy of the Word of God to Numbers